Warning, this review may contain spoilers, strong language, violence, and content of a graphic nature. It may not be suitable for some viewers. Viewer discretion is advised.
Hi, welcome to another Trick or Treat Horrorfest. I'm your host, DJ Surreal with Descent Sundays. Today we're going to talk about the cell. Before we get into the review, let's see that trailer. You spend most of your time in the mind of a serial killer, and the way that they visually represent things is quite interesting, and I really enjoy the artistic feel of the film. I also like the fact that there's all these different elements of subconscious and conscious mind at play, and yet they sort of allude to you like what's on the forefront of people's minds by introducing certain thoughts and the way that certain thoughts actually appear within the film, like when they bring in the dog and the dog's licking his hands. As soon as they go back into his mind, the dog is there, right? It's all those nice little touches. I also like the fact that with the cell, you get to see a monster from a different perspective. I really enjoy this film for showing us the different side of the monster. You really get the idea that, you know, he was torturing himself as much as he was torturing other people, and that the other people that he tortured, he didn't even see them that way. That wasn't actually even part of his psyche. It was all part of his internal torment, basically perpetuated by the abuse that he suffered. It sort of gives you a very different feel of a very horrible person. And I kind of like the fact that the therapist, she sort of bonds with him a little bit. And they even say in the end of the movie where they're like, oh, she's keeping his dog. How weird is that? And, you know, the other detective who is also, you know, ended up making the journey into the mine was all like, oh, yeah, that's super weird. But meanwhile, he's really like, yeah, I get it. You know? I also really liked the little boy and how he represented the innocence that still existed in the mind of this killer, and how he actually was the one to suggest and bring about the end for the serial killer and the end of his torment. I think that this movie plays with a lot of different ideas on a psychological level, and it talks a lot, like, it doesn't specifically talk about, but there's a lot that can be read into about how we internalize and visualize who we are and how that plays into what we do and what our opinions or our internal visualizations of other people and how that actually presents within our own minds. So it was a very interesting different sort of take on a horror movie, and I also like that they were able to visually represent certain schizophrenic elements and what it might actually sound like. For example,
what the fuck?
Have you seen him? My boy, my little one. His father took him from me. Spit him out my hole. Big deal. Don't mean I got my child's an abomination. He has no soul.
What that can sound like for someone who has those sort of mental health issues. Overall, I'd have to say the cell is a bit of a treat. I not your typical gore, horror, slasher flick, but more of a psychological thriller and horror with a little bit of sci-fi shown in. So it's definitely pretty great. Hey, thanks so much for joining me, and I'll see you tomorrow for another horror movie review. A horror movie, or fuck. Yes, it's a horror movie. Fucking hell. Okay.
This one we got coming for you is a nice curveball. It's a romantic comedy.
Okay. To really start really digging into the whole idea of that's a total lie, I shouldn't say that.